Hello everyone, welcome to PCB e-classes. This is a lecture number 5 on Kirchhoff's law. Let's get started. There are two laws in the Kirchhoff's law. One is Kirchhoff's current law, which is otherwise known as KCL. Fine. And the second one is Kirchhoff's voltage law, that is said to the KVL. This is Kirchhoff's voltage law. Kirchhoff's current law is following law of conservation of charge. Law of conservation of charge, whereas the KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, follows law of conservation of energy. We'll discuss it later, what is the meaning of these all, but still, as we have taken the name of the law of conservation of charge and the energy, we'll define. What is this law of conservation of charge is saying? Law of conservation of charge is saying that a charge can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be transferred from one point to the another. This is the law of conservation of charge definition. The same thing. Law of conservation of energy, what it says, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, rather it can be transferred from one point to another, or one form to another, right? This is the definition of the, or this is the statement of the law of conservation of energy as well as a charge. Now first we'll discuss about the KCL, Kirchhoff's current law. Fine. We'll define the Kirchhoff's current law. Statement. What we'll see? Statement. It states that Kirchhoff's current law states that the algebraic sum of currents entering and leaving at a node or junction is zero. What does it mean? Suppose we'll take, it is referred to the node or junction. Fine. Suppose I am taking this as a node or a junction. What is a node? Node is basically a common point for several branches, for two or more branches. It is a common point. Suppose from here four branches are linked, and the current flowing here is taken as I1, I2, I3, and this is I4. Fine. So four branches are connected and the current direction is given. Clear? And what are the currents flowing through it? Flowing through the branches. Now what it says, the algebraic sum of the currents entering and leaving at a junction, node or a junction, is zero, right? So here some notations are there that we have to consider. What it says, if current enters
then that will be taken as positive, right? If current leaves, that will be taken as negative. Fine. So as per that one, we will see here. At a node, at this node, we'll see what is the current I1 is entering or leaving. It's entering. So entering current will be taken as positive. So plus I1. Similarly, I2 plus I2 plus I3. I3 is entering, but I4 is leaving. That is I4 equals to 0. This is what the KCL is stating. Fine. This is what it states. Now, as I have said, these are the conditions. These conditions are not always same. A different book, it will be different. Fine. Analysis may be different. So, in some book, it will be taken as entering as negative, leaving as negative, positive, opposite. Fine. So, as per the opposite also, if I'll take it, what I'll get it? The same equation I will be getting it. If I will take this one as negative and this one as positive. Fine. So as per that one, what I will write down here? Minus I1. Minus I1. Minus I2. Minus I3. Plus I4 equals to 0. This is also the KCL. Why I am saying mathematically both are correct? Because if I'll take the entire equation to the right hand side, then it will be the same. So either of the indications are correct. You may take this one as positive, negative, or negative, positive, it doesn't matter. But the sign should be different for entering and the leaving. This is one type of statement of the Kirchhoff's current law. In another way, also we are defining it. Let us see that definition. Fine. What is the next one? Definition it says other way. Other way definition of the KCL is the sum of current entering and sum of current leaving from a node, from a particular node is same. What is the meaning? Let us see the same example. I'll take it. Let us take the, it is a node. We have four branches. Fine. Here the current is entering. This is I1. This is I2. This is I3 and I4. Here which one? What I'm saying here? Sum of current entering. So I'll take this one as entering part. And this one is leaving part. Fine. Sum of the current entering. What is it? I1 plus I2 plus I3. This is the entering part. And sum of the current leaving. How many currents are there? Leaving? One. So it is I4. These two are equal. These two are equal. Fine. The meaning is same, exactly the same as the previous one. Let us see here. This can be written as I1 plus I2 plus I3 minus I4 equals to 0, which can be otherwise written as minus I1 minus I1 minus I2 minus I3
plus I4 equals to 0. All three equations are same. So KCL can be defined in both the ways. Two statements I have given it. Fine. Let us move to the KVL. Kirchhoff's voltage law. Kirchhoff's voltage law, what it is saying? Its statement starts with a particular condition. In a closed loop, the sum of EMF and voltage drops are zero. You can write down this one, is or R. Voltage drops the condition that is a closed loop. I'll take a closed loop, right? I'm taking a circuit which is having one element resistance, another element as resistance, fine, and it has been supplied by a battery, fine. This is R1, this is R2, and this is a voltage given as V. Now, naturally, in which direction the current will be flowing? From positive terminal of the battery, the current will be flowing. So, let us take this current is flowing from positive to the clockwise direction. In the clockwise direction, the current is flowing. Let us take this one as the I. Fine. As soon as the current enters here, already I have said it, as soon as it enters to this element R1, its polarity will become positive, its polarity will become negative. Similarly, this polarity will become positive, this will become negative. Fine. And naturally, this one is a positive plate, this one is a negative plate of the battery. Now, how we have to apply the KVL? Before applying the KVL, just make a note of these two points. If it is a drop in voltage or voltage drop, we used to say it, across element it will be there, or across any element it will be there, fine. This will be taken as negative. Fine. And if it is rise in voltage or potential, then it will be taken as positive. Fine. These two things we have to take care of it. Before moving to the KVL, we should know about this voltage drop and the rise in voltage, how to note it. If the current travels from positive to negative, then it will be said as drop. Whereas, if the current is traveling from negative to positive, then this will be said as rise in potential.
the same one we'll apply the KVL, right? In a proper way we'll apply it. What I've said it, if it is rise in potential, if it is rise in potential, then we have to take that one as positive. If it is drop in potential, then we have to take negative. So let us see here. Current enters in the negative and comes out from the positive. So it is a rise in potential or the drop in potential? Rise in potential. So we will be taking this one as positive plus V. Fine. Next, current enters in the positive, leaves negative. So it is drop in potential. So I'll be taking this one as drop means negative. What is the current entering here? I into R. From Ohm's law, we know that is the V equals to I into R. So it is I into R1. Similarly here, positive to negative. So it is minus I into R2 equals to 0. Fine. What is this one? This is the KVL equation. KVL equation. Fine. What the KVL equation says? Sum of the EMF. What is the EMF here? Voltage battery. And potential drops. These are the drops. Summation of this one as well as this one is equals to 0. But the thing is, the notations or the signs are different. But for the standard notation, for easier and the quicker way to solve the problems, what I'll do, I'll take its positive and negative opposite, then also it will be the same one. Let us see here. If I'll take for the standard notation, I'm taking for the standard notation, standard notation, that is rise in potential, I'm taking this one as, that was taken positive, this one I'm taking as negative, and the drop in potential, I'm taking this one as positive. The meaning will be same. Let us see that one. So opposite, so I have taken here positive, so I'll take here this one as negative minus V. Next, this one is positive I into R1, positive I into R2 equals to 0, which implies if I write down this one, I'll take this one on the right hand side, then it will V minus I into R1 minus I into R2 equals to 0, which is the same equation what we have got earlier. Fine, this will be positive. Clear? It's also the KVL equation. This is also the KVL equation. Fine. So what I'll do, I'll take this one in a different way. I'll take the standard notation, wherever the current is entering, that sign I'll take it. Then it will be better for me to get the standard notation. Fine. So see here, where the current enters? Current enters in the negative. So what is this one? This I'm taking as for the standard notation, I'm taking where it enters negative. So it is minus V. Where the current enters positive or negative? Positive. So I'm taking this one as plus I into R1. Wherever it is entering positive or negative? Positive. I into R2 equals to 0. Thus, we got the standard notation of the KVL. Fine. So in this way, we'll be finding out, we'll be applying the KVL and the KCL to analyze the electrical circuit. Clear? In order to analyze the problems, what we'll be doing in the future classes, in that we'll be applying the KVL and the KCL in the same way. Fine. This is all about the Kirchhoff's law in this lecture. The rest we'll be discussing in the next lecture. Thank you.